Hello and welcome to Christ Lutheran Church's first video of three looking at the second article of the Creed. Everyone in the world has to deal with the fact that Jesus existed. Because Jesus is just different from everyone else. Jesus is just different. His very existence among us demands that we figure out what he is all about. Here's how the French Emperor Napoleon Bonaparte put it. I know men, and I tell you that Jesus Christ is no mere man. Between him and every other person in the world, there is no possible term of comparison. Alexander, Caesar, Charlemagne, and I have founded empires, but on what did we rest the creations of our genius? Upon force. Jesus Christ founded his empire upon love, and at this hour, millions of men would die for him. Jesus is the most special person to ever walk on the earth. But it's not just that Jesus is special or different. He's also very, very important. Here's how Jesus himself put it in John chapter 14. Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So, who is Jesus? Well, there are some passages in the Bible that help us think through who Jesus is. The first is when Jesus calmed the storm on the water. Here is what it says in Matthew chapter 8. He, Jesus, got into the boat and his disciples followed him. Suddenly, a furious storm came up on the lake so that the waves swept over the boat, but Jesus was sleeping. The disciples went and woke him, saying, Lord, save us, we're going to drown. He replied, You have little faith. Why are you so afraid? Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm. The men were amazed and asked, What kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him. They asked a good question at the end there, didn't they? But we get some great answers right here in this account. First, we see Jesus doing normal human things, including sleeping. Jesus shows us that he really is a human. But look what he did to the winds and the waves. He authoritatively, like God speaking over the whole creation, told the winds and the waves to immediately calm down. And they obeyed, which means that Jesus is not only human, but also God. Like I said, Jesus is the most special person to ever walk on the earth. No other human has ever also been God. And God the Father and God the Holy Spirit have never also been human. Only the Son of God is both. In fact, Jesus is fully human. And we know this because he did what God cannot do. He died. And look at another passage from the next chapter in Matthew's gospel. It says, Jesus stepped into a boat, crossed over, and came to his own town. Some men brought to him a paralyzed man lying on a mat. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the man, Take heart, son, your sins are forgiven. At this, some of the teachers of the law said to themselves, This fellow is blaspheming. Knowing their thoughts, Jesus said, Why do you entertain evil thoughts in your hearts? Which is easier, to say, Your sins are forgiven, or to say, Get up and walk? But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. So he said to the paralyzed man, Get up, take your mat, and go home. Then the man got up and went home. When the crowd saw this, they were filled with awe, and they praised God who had given such authority to man. Wow. Do you see what Jesus did here? He gave a healing, sort of like when he calmed the waves, he showed his power over creation, but then he showed what his authority, his divine, godly authority, really allowed him to do. It allowed him to forgive sins, to actually have an impact on God's eternal opinion of sinners. Isn't that amazing? The Bible sometimes pictures all the believers as names in a book up in heaven, and Jesus has access to that book. It's his book, which means that Jesus is not just fully human, able to get tired and even die, but also fully God, with authority not only over creation, but also over where we will end up after our time on earth is done. There's a lot that we're exploring here, but really, it's this simple. Jesus Christ is fully God and fully human. That's why the Creed says, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. I love this too. In Romans 6, verse 4, it says, Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father. So God the Father raised God the Son who had died. But in John chapter 10, Jesus put it this way, the reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life, only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. Jesus had the power to raise himself from the dead. This one who could die could also defeat death. He is easily the most important person ever. He is fully God and fully human. People have tried to come up with other explanations for who Jesus was. They don't get these ideas from the Bible, but by just guessing or having a preference in their heart that they have suggested to others. Now, here are some of these other ideas. Arianism says that Jesus didn't exist, hasn't been God from eternity, but then he did exist. Marcionism says that Jesus is a new God, different from the God we read about in the Old Testament, the books from before Jesus walked on the earth. Modalism says that over time, God has given up old modes and taken up new ones, first being the Father in the Old Testament, then the Son in the New Testament, and now the Holy Spirit in the life of the church. Docetism says that Jesus only seemed human, but really he has only ever been God. And adoptionism says that Jesus serves merely as an example for us, not as someone to trust in, because he worked his way up from being a human to being a God. The Christian church has had to wrestle with these ideas and look back to the Bible and discover what it is that God has shown us about who Jesus is. In the Bible, God makes it clear. Jesus is fully God and fully human. When we look at church history and see people wrestling with these things, we cherish those Christians who asked, how can we be careful with what's taught in the Bible so that needy souls can find real help? And that is right in line with what it says in Romans chapter 15. Everything that was written in the past was written to teach us so that through endurance, the endurance taught in the scriptures and the encouragement they provide, we might have hope. Here's your home activity. Read Colossians chapter 1, verses 15 through 20, and then answer these questions. First, what's your favorite statement or phrase about Jesus in this passage? And then what makes you choose that statement or phrase? That's all for this time. God bless.